Welcome back. When the Honourable Michael Kirby stepped down in 2009 after 13 years as a High Court Justice, nobody really expected he'd go quietly into the night. But now the distinguished judge may have taken on his biggest challenge. As head of the first ever UN investigation into human rights abuses in North Korea, he's gathering evidence about the secret state. The question is, will his work make any difference whatsoever to Pyongyang's hardliners, all those countries trying to engage with the Hermit Kingdom? Here's Yorubu Melham.
This is the North Korea that is paraded to the world. A spectacle of military might and national unity. But today, a world away in London's Westminster, a landmark UN inquiry will reveal a very different reality.
I'm Michael Kirby, and I am the chair of the Commission of Inquiry.
Led by former High Court Judge Michael Kirby, a distinguished team has assembled, and the media is out in force at this rare chance to peer inside the secret state.
And I call forward the first such witness, Mr. Kim Song-ju.
북한에서는 이거를 자칭해 가지고 누구든지 이 감옥에 들어오면은 짐승이다라고 표현을 합니다. 방에 들어가면 일단 허락 없이 일어날 수가 없고 앉아 있는 상태에서 40명에서 50명 정도가 바로 움직일 수도 없고 누울 수도 없어요.
Starvation forced Kim Song-ju to try to flee to China. He was caught and sent to a labor camp.
한 끼 음식은 양이 한 주먹만 정도 그런 정도의 양인데 이제 옥수수를 가루낸 것인데 그 안에는 그 옥수수 겨도 그대로 있고 먼지도 그대로 있고 돌도 그대로 있고 그걸 갈아서 물을 넣고
며칠 일어나서 운동도 하셨어요.
Park Ji-young fled the country after threats from the military.
제가 2월 21일 이제 떠날 때 저희 차가운 방에 저희 아버지 아직 숨 그대로 계시는 걸 눕혀두시고 쌀 한 공기와 사실은 그래 지금까지도 저희 아버지가 정확하게 돌아가신 날짜하고 어디 묻힌 걸 제가 모르거든요.
Kim Ju-il is a former soldier.
입대하기 전까지 체험한 사실은 세 번 정도가 되고요. 그리고 처음으로 경험했던 나이는 10살 때
Kirby has been inundated with requests from defectors to tell their stories about life in the labor camps and prisons.
군에서 벌어지는 모든 문제에 그런 행위를 범한 사람들은 대부분 다 군법에 의해서 여기에 가서 교화를 통해서도 노동을 통해서 이렇게 숙련이 되는데요. 완전 통제 구역처럼 나오지 못하는 사람들도 있지.
So secret are these camps, it's taken satellite imagery to reveal their location. An estimated 200,000 people have disappeared into this network. Despite all the evidence to the contrary, North Korea denies their existence. Kirby doesn't buy that.
Even today, I saw new images of a particular camp, Camp 16, which is in the north eastern corner of North Korea, which has not been fully described before.
There is almost no footage from inside these camps. This extremely rare vision, allegedly smuggled out by a defector, is thought to be Camp 15, Yodok labor camp in the country's east.
The prison camps are extremely cruel and of every five who enter, about two leave as a corpse or don't leave at all.
Witnesses have described how whole families, including children, are committed to a life of hard labour. Few escape, but some who have recorded the horror. These drawings have been compiled over many years.
Prisoners have to collect the bodies. They have to collect them on carts, drag them to a pot and set them on fire, and This is testimony which is believable in the context of the humiliating circumstances and particularly the lack of proper food, which is the daily life of a prisoner. I was a judge for 34 years in Australia and I saw plenty of harrowing stories.
But all those years on the bench didn't prepare him for the horror of North Korea.
I felt on the verge of tears, if not felt tears, because these are human beings who have shared with you when they didn't have to.
When Park Ji-young told her story, it defied imagination. Not only did she escape leaving her dying father, she fell into the hands of people traffickers who sold her into marriage.
Did they harass you sexually? Or?
No.
Eventually you gave birth to a boy in this marriage?
No.
Today, Ji-young lives with her second husband and children in the north of England. Inside, I meet the eldest of her three children, Chul-hee. When he was only four, his mother was arrested by the Chinese and sent back to North Korea. There, she was sentenced to years of hard labor in a prison camp. Though she could barely walk, Ji-young eventually escaped again.
머리가 다 새노랗게 되색돼가고만 사람 다 죽어가게 되고 뭐 머맨이 있잖아요. 이가 막 끼고 있잖아요. 거진 완전 죽은 사람이나 한 가지였거든요. 그
When she got to China, she was desperate to find her son.
전화를 해갖고 아들이 지금 살아있는 거기 있는가만 저는 지금 먼저 확인하는 거잖아요. 전화를 했는데 아들이 있대요. 너무 반가워하고 애를 바꿔달라니까 전화를 받았다가 엄마 한마디하고 난 막 우는 거예요. 너무 서러워가지고
Together, they joined a group of North Koreans crossing the border into Mongolia.
저기 지금 또 중국 차가 또 지금 밤에 순찰을 오는 거예요. 어쩔 수가 없어요. 그거 어떻게 해요? 그러면 군다고 해서 애를 뭐 어떻게 할 수도 없고. 근데 이제 그때 이제 한 사람이 막 와갖고 이제 애를 들쳐갖고 제 손 쥐고 이제 막 뛰어가는 거예요. 뛰어가갖고.
The man who rescued Ji-young and her son, another North Korean escapee, is her husband today. We can't reveal his identity as he fears for family still in North Korea.
제 목숨 내놓고 그렇게 막 뛰어가고 다시 먼저 구해갖고 그래서 지금 안에 가서 여기 살아 있는 거지.
And now Ji-young frequently speaks out about the situation in her homeland.
또 인권이 개선될 수 있고 또
Back at the commission, the former army officer, Kim Ju-il, continues his testimony.
언젠가는 북한 주민의 스스로 손으로 북한 주민의 인권을 찾는 그날이 반드시 오고야 말 것이라는 확신을 가지고 있습니다.
Ju-il says he fled North Korea after he began questioning the regime. Arriving in the UK, he started this newspaper, but the memories of his former life haunt him.
역전군에 사람들이 그렇게 가득한데 간첩 구석에는 시신들이 역전에서 많이 굶어주어서 구자듯이 굶어죽기 때문에 막 구석에 보면 그 시신이 방치돼 있거든요. 지금 이 칼럼은 이 박정도 목사 계속 쓰겠다는 거야 매번.
He hopes his newspaper will counter the propaganda from Pyongyang, and wants one day to have it smuggled into North Korea. Jong-il's newspaper office is above this supermarket. He comes here almost every day. It's a constant reminder of his homeland and its brutal rulers.
카메라가 들어갈 수 없는데 카메라가 들어가면 안에는 북한 탈북민들 직원들도 일을 하고 있기 때문에 본인들이 카메라에 얼굴이 나오는 걸 원치 않아서 오늘 들어갈 수가 없고요. 유럽에 있는 북한 대사관 직원들도 가끔은 이 슈퍼마켓을 이용을 하거든요. 전에 제가 왔을 때 잠깐 북한 대사관 직원들하고 마주친 일도 있었고, 저희가 말을 시키려고 하면 그분들이 알아서 피하거든요. 그래서 말을 할 수가 없고 오늘.
Today, the commissioners are on their way to the parliament. Justice Kirby is preoccupied with the important task that lies ahead.
I don't believe in making banal conversation on the street. I'm concentrating on what follows now.
When the committee's report is written, the judge doesn't want it to gather dust on a shelf somewhere. They've come to lobby the government. Lord David Alton chairs the all-party parliamentary group on North Korea.
It's a special pleasure and an honour in welcoming Mr. Justice Kirby to our proceedings today. You have a very distinguished judicial record in Australia, and
Kirby wastes no time making his point.
It will simply be a shattered opportunity if, having created the Commission of Inquiry and having raised so many hopes of people in so many countries, not only in Korea but around the world, if giving the report is deemed to be enough. It's not enough, it is simply the beginning.
I promise you, for my own part anyway, I will leave no stone unturned in ensuring that it is given a proper airing here in Parliament, but also the pressure is placed on our own government.
But as the cult of the leader continues unabated in North Korea, it seems this most inward-looking of nations doesn't bend to world opinion. Kirby says the time has come to challenge that.
There is a realization that this has really gone beyond the pale and that there's a very serious problem here that needs to be addressed. And I hope and I believe that the United Nations and the countries who are members of the United Nations will answer the test.
Those who poured out their hearts here today will be hoping he's right.
Thank you for staying all day.
Thank you very much. Interest
Yes, that's my duty. It is my duty.
Thank you. Yes,
thank you very much.